Coming up, the prowler who was seen looking into a Cal Poly student's bedroom window has been arrested.
Cal Poly students and city leaders come together to plan out how the city will fight against climate change.
Annual on-campus parking passes can be expensive, but alternative forms of transportation could help you save money.
Broadcasting from Swanson Studios, you're watching Mustang News.
Hello and welcome to Mustang News. I'm Carissa Rotkowski.
And I'm Lauren Wallachy. Here are today's top stories. 2 weeks ago, a man was seen looking into the bedroom window of a Cal Poly student. And on Saturday, the suspect was arrested. Mustang News reporter Maya McGregor has more on the prowling case.
Residents of Hathaway Avenue woke up to police cars and another prowler on their block on Saturday. Officers received reports of a man looking into a student's bedroom window on the 100 block of Hathaway Avenue. The suspect, identified as 55-year-old Sean Anderson, was eventually arrested and booked in the San Luis Obispo County Jail. 2 weeks earlier, third-year liberal studies major Selena Sherfain saw the prowler outside of her own bedroom window. And around midnight on Saturday, she walked outside to find more police cars at her house.
We went to the police and we asked them, and they said that they caught him, and he was at the house next door.
Anderson was booked for prowling, peeping, and resisting arrest, with bail set at $10,000. He has since posted bail.
I was still anxious when he got put in jail because I feel like it's very common to happen in a college town, so I was still kind of anxious. So him being out didn't really change my feelings.
This is not Anderson's first offense. In 2003, he was convicted of sexual battery and assault with the intent to commit a specified sex offense. SLO PD also encourages students to immediately report suspicious activity, as waiting could make it more difficult to identify and capture predators. For Mustang News, I'm Maya McGregor.
The San Luis Obispo Police Department is encouraging students to keep outside lights on at night and to make sure doors and windows are locked.
Cal Poly students and city leaders met on campus Tuesday to discuss the city's plan to fight against climate change. Reporter Leanna Newby tells us more about this event.
Sustainability Month at Cal Poly is giving students the chance to share their ideas for climate action change. On October 8th, the city of San Luis Obispo hosted a climate action plan workshop with the Cal Poly SLO Green Campus Club.
So a climate action plan is a guiding document for the city to follow for reaching its carbon neutrality goal, which has been set for 2035. We have made some major strides, major policy strides as well. We've almost achieved 100% carbon-free energy.
Workshop participants brainstormed ideas concerning green energy, clean active transportation, green buildings, zero waste, and open space and sequestration.
SLO has actually set the most ambitious goals out of the entire nation as far as the city goes, which is really exciting. And we had a pretty unique relationship with like a SLO government as Cal Poly, so it's really nice to have an active role in the climate action plan, because a lot of like regular citizens don't, and students don't have a lot of opportunities to get engaged in that kind of thing.
Cal Poly is increasing awareness by promoting various sustainability events throughout the entire month of October. For more information on these upcoming events, visit the Cal Poly Sustainability Facebook page.
San Luis Obispo is a huge part of your lives, and the changes that happen are going to severely impact the way you live your life and the way that SLO operates as a city, like the city that we all like, know and love. So it's pretty important to keep up to date and kind of have an active voice of what you want to see that city like, turn into.
For MNTV, I'm Leanna Newby.
The next sustainability event this month is a sustainability speed dating event, which will take place October 15th from 6 to 8 p.m.
Jake, it's been a bit chilly the past few days. What can we expect looking into the weekend?
It's going to be hot. More on the heat spike this weekend after the break.
What do you think you're doing, Kevin?
I was just going to drive home.
There are several warning signs present that you shouldn't be driving.
Like hearing voices?
Like your text to emoji ratio?
Oh, man, the selfies.
Selfie nailed it.
We all have warning signs that let us know that we're probably not okay to drive. Mine is pretending to be your subconscious.
Craig, come on, man, let's put a ride home.
Hey, Bobo, do trees tell each other stories?
I'm sorry, I'm afraid I don't know that.
Hey, why don't we go find out? Listen.
Can birds draw pictures?
I don't have an answer for that.
Dad, do stars visit their friends?
Look!
How's it going, folks? Today, I got your weather. So today we're looking at a high of 77 and a low of 52. So it's going to be a little warm today, but don't worry, things will cool off as they usually do at nighttime. It's going to be sunny with a 0% chance of rain and 31% humidity. Southwest winds from 5 miles an hour to 10 miles an hour. That's going to slow on down to just a nice, consistent, easy breeze of 5 miles per hour. Moving on up the 101 to North County, we're going to be seeing weather ranging from the high 70s to the low 80s, so just keep that in mind. Very cold nights, though, weirdly enough, so you're getting a kind of a big gap in the daytime to nighttime temperatures, you know, with 39 in Creston, 38 in Paso. Moving on down south, we're getting a bit more of a consistent look at the weather, you know, very, very consistent temperatures, you know, 77 from Santa Maria to Orcutt, and then moving down to Vandenberg, we're actually getting pretty cool with 71 and 46. Also in Guadalupe and Arroyo Grande, a nice, easy 71 and 72. So, you know, nothing too warm. Moving on down to the beaches, we're going to be seeing more consistent weather as well. And for the five-day forecast, we're going to see a huge heat spike on Friday and Saturday, but it'll cool off in the early week. That's all I got for the weather. Now I'm going to toss it on over to Andrew for sports. Go deep!
Thanks, Jake. Here's your latest Cal Poly sports update. Cal Poly's volleyball's biggest match of the season is coming up. They will host the 19th-ranked Hawaii on Friday night. It will be a titanic matchup inside Mott Athletic Center. The Mustangs are on a 7-match winning streak and are undefeated in the Big West Conference. But now, the Rainbow, Wahine are nationally ranked for a reason, having only lost 2 matches this season. For the past 2 years, this matchup has been a sellout.
It literally gives me goosebumps thinking about it right now. Like, it is insane. I remember last year as a freshman, like, I walked out and I didn't really know what to expect. And I was just like, my jaw dropped. Like, everyone is there and they are loud and supporting and the band is there. And it is unreal how amazing it is. And it helps way more than fans probably even know.
The Mustangs are led by junior outside hitter Maya Dvorak, their biggest offensive threat, hitting a .224 with 3.77 kills per set. Last season, Cal Poly claimed its second consecutive Big West championship, just 1 win of the second place Hawaii. The Mustangs are also looking to extend the nation's longest home winning streak of 27 matches. The Big West Showdown will be played tomorrow at 7 p.m. While Cal Poly baseball is well into their season, the off-season recruiting is heating up. Head coach Larry Lee spoke about how recruiting has changed over his past 20 years here.
With the recruiting, it's getting more difficult. One, there's a bigger discrepancy between us and the bigger conferences like the Pac-12, just the resources they get. High school kids, they want to go to the bigger conferences. There's more of a lure. They're on TV. They're talked about all the time. They have big-time athletic programs. And I think the main thing that really hurts us out west is that 10 years ago, there weren't a lot of colleges outside of the West coming in and getting players, but now the entire country's in California.
Baseball returns in February for the Talking Stick Tournament in Scottsdale, Arizona. And looking to the weekend, we've got a few Mustang matchups ahead of us. Football is heading to UC Davis Saturday to face the Aggies at 4 p.m. Women's soccer will travel Thursday to take on CSU Northridge starting at 7 p.m., Men's tennis will travel down to Santa Barbara this Friday, October 11th, to compete in the UCSB Classic, which will continue through Sunday, October 13th. That's all I have for sports news this week. Now back to Lauren and Chris at the desk.
Thanks, Andrew. Coming up after the break, a new club brings together hummus lovers at Cal Poly.
And parking on campus can be hard to find.
They call me Maxie, but I prefer tripod.
I was your above average four-legged homie, and then wham, bam, minivan. Some people pity me. Now that's lame. I still run, fetch, and swim. And the ladies love me. I'm the ultimate wingman. Just don't ask me to high five.
Let me tell you about the toughest guy on earth.
He has the crazy strength to lift the man that raised him up without even flinching.
This guy, no, this warrior, will always be by his father's side, even if his dad will hardly remember. If this guy isn't the toughest guy on the planet, then I don't know who is. Caregiving is tougher than tough. Find the care guides you need at aarp.org/caregiving.
The Hummus Club may be new to Cal Poly, but it has grown very quickly. Reporter Jessica Sharp has more on how this club got started.
What originally started as a quest between Natalie and Katie to meet other people, Cal Poly's Hummus Club has now become a club to watch. The club revolves around the act of eating and appreciating hummus, and of course, the opportunity to meet new people.
So I think we mostly did it like for ourselves, because we did want our like little community of it. And I, at least for me, I can't speak for Natalie, like I kind of thought it was just gonna be like a little club that like some people wanted to join, but it'd be mostly like our friends. But then everyone, once we started it, everyone kept talking to us and they're like, oh my God, hummus club, I would join that. And then we started talking about it and we're like, man, either this is gonna like, you know, poop out and it's not gonna like go anywhere, or it's just gonna be like this giant thing. And it's kind of turning into a giant thing, which is crazy.
We also talked to club member Dave LaMotto on what he was most excited for in terms of the Hummus Club.
I haven't really expanded my hummus tastings into like crazier categories of hummus, so I'm excited to try like, you know, some new flavors I've never experienced before.
In which leadership positions will be available and club funding will be possible.
I love hummus. I love all types of hummus. I've always loved hummus. So that's why I joined the Hummus Club. Come and join us.
For more information on how to get involved, check out their Facebook page at Cal Poly Hummus Club.
Commuter car parking costs and time can add up, but there are some ways to park on campus. Many Cal Poly students and staff have to commute to campus every day. Commuter car parking passes are $450 to $630 depending on the permit. Whether you buy an annual pass or pay a meter, parking can add up.
I thought that by getting a parking pass, I would be able to drive to school in as much time it takes me to get to school, so less than 10 minutes. But instead I leave over 30 minutes before class starts. And even at that, I'll circle the lot and be stuck in traffic for a good 25 minutes.
Some students and staff choose to ride mopeds and motorcycles to campus instead and buy a motorcycle parking pass for the $150 for the year.
This past Sunday, vendors gathered in Shell Beach for the monthly event, Art in the Park. Art in the Park takes place each month at Dinosaur Caves Park in Shell Beach and attracts over 60 local artists and vendors. Ruth Maddox, owner of Ruth's Herbal Remedies, has attended Art in the Park for the past 16 years.
It's one of the few shows where everyone has to make their own products. And it's just nice because it's a good location and a lot of locals come at this time of year. I saw most of my customers today were locals.
Art in the Park takes place on the first Sunday of each month from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Enjoy live music and ocean views while checking out local artists and vendors. For more information, check out Art in the Park at shellbeach.com. That's all we have for you today. For full campus coverage, visit mustangnews.net. I'm Lauren Wallachy.
And I'm Carissa Rotkowski. Have a great rest of your day.